All right, guys, I'm gonna go ahead and demonstrate how to draft this hood. Really what we're doing, we're just gonna follow the instructions from the textbook, but we're just gonna apply them in clothes. So it's a little tricky because we're not doing it by hand. So, you know, we'll have to make some modifications, but anyways, I'm gonna demonstrate it. This is actually my first time doing this. You're welcome to follow along. You do not have to do it the way I'm doing it because in clothes there is more than one way to do things. And, you know, and sometimes I take these instructions with a grain of salt. You know, they're just kind of a means to get us to that first proto, and then you would probably do some fits anyways. So, yeah, there's my disclaimer. So you can make changes if you want. But anyways, here's how I'm going to do it, and follow along if you like, or just watch. Okay, so they're giving us step-by-steps. We should already have our basic measurements. The book initially asked us to take two measurements. We actually really only need the overhead measurement because in this demonstration, I'm gonna be demoing the loose hood foundation. So they don't really care about the horizontal measurement. They're just gonna kind of double the overhead measurement that you initially took, or not double, they're just gonna use that measurement instead of a more exact around the head measurement. So you only need one measurement. Mine was 9.33. I'll be using that. And then we're just gonna follow the steps on how to draft it. Again, because we're doing this in clo, we actually need to first draft just a big piece of fabric. That'll be like our paper or pattern paper, if you will, if we were in the classroom doing it by hand. And then we'll draw internal lines on it, or just add points on that big piece of fabric. And then at the end, we'd probably use a trace tool to pull it out. So that's my plan going into this. Let's see what happens. So I need a big piece of fabric. Here's the avatar's head. So I would assume the piece of fabric should be, you know, around that size. Here's the tool to draw fabric. I'm gonna use the rectangle, keyboard shortcut letter S. And I'm just gonna, I mean, this is probably way too big, but hey, there you go. Oh. Let's see here. I'll just make my fabric. There you go. Your fabric is probably on this setting. Okay. So there we go. I have some fabric. They also tell you, really these instructions are for design one, but if you like design two, the only thing you have to do is take your, overhead measurement and add another 2 inches. So just by making it 2 inches bigger, we'll get you design number two. I think I'm just going to shoot for design one, but I just wanted to bring that to your attention. Okay, so A to B is my overhead measurement. For me, it was 9.33. So maybe what I could do, just kind of, maybe I'll just put a point in here. I'll hit the letter X, and I'm just going to click right here, and that's going to be my letter A. So I am, maybe to make this like visually easier for everyone to follow along, I'll use this little text tool, and I'll type in the letter A so that we know. Okay, somehow I defaulted to my clear fabric. I don't know why, but whatever, I'll just go with it. Okay, so now we need to do B. So I'll hit X again, and this time I'll right click, and that way I can type in 9.33 and say okay. And that gets to be letter B, so I'll go back to this little text tool and type in the letter B. Okay, the next step is to add letter C, which is gonna be 2.5 inches. They just threw out that number. That's to make it oversized. So there you go. This is something we could always change later during a fitting. So I guess I'll hit the letter X, and I'm gonna right click, and we will type in 2.5. Say okay. I'll go ahead and label this for everyone so that we know that this is letter C. Okay. Okay. C to D, they want that to be the measurement of A to B, and my A to B was 9.33. So they want a straight line squared out from C. So I think the easiest way to do this is to hit the letter Z and select only the letter, the point at C, and right click, and we can add an internal perpendicular line that shoots out. I want this line going on the x-axis across, so perpendicular from it would be y, which is so weird. Okay, I digress. There we go. Do I want to make it a certain length? They haven't really, oh yeah, I do, that's right. I want it 9.33. Oh, not my angle. Oh, shoot. 90 degrees. There we are. Length. Let's change that to 9.33. That looks good. Okay. Okay. Then they want us to square straight down. Oh, I should probably label that D just so that we can not get too confused, right? Then we want to square this straight down. Is that right? As shown. Okay. So I'll hit the letter Z. I'm going to grab that point. I'm going to right click. I think maybe I'll just say extend trim to pattern outline. Oh, nope. Edit undo. How about add perpendicular line? It needs to be on the Y axis going up and down, so I have to make it perpendicular from X. It's going the wrong way. I'll say reverse, and that looks good. Okay. Here we go. Okay. Now we need to get our center back pattern piece and place it on the A to C line with the corner of our neck touching A, and we're going to draw the neck to the corner of the shoulder. So we're basically going to trace the neckline is what's happening. So let's get our back pattern piece. Make sure you're in the A tool to select it. I guess we have to rotate it. I think I'll just right click and say flip vertically. So it's like upside down. And then I'm going to put this guy on the letter A. I should definitely zoom in. This pattern piece is a little crooked, isn't it? Maybe I'll use this rotation button to kind of get it straighter. Zooming in, panning. Okay, where is it? Uh-oh, I moved my fabric. There we go. Cool. I think I got it right on the A. And trying to think, am I able to copy this? We basically want this neckline shape. That's what we want. So I could just trace it with the internal line. Right now, again, my fabric is on, well, it's supposed to be on the transparency. I hit some weird tool. What happens if I don't know what I hit. I hate when I do that. Okay. Yeah, if yours looks like this, then it's going to be hard to trace it, right? Because it's underneath. So make sure you're on the transparent. There's like a couple, maybe like the translucent ones. You can kind of see through it, or you can just totally do transparent. I don't know if I'm able to right click and just copy and paste it. I mean, it might just be easier to just trace it with the letter G, the internal line. So I think I'll just do that. So I'll click right here. I see there's a point there. So I'm going to hold command and just click right on that point. And then come down and just click one. I'm going to double click. Click, click. Okay. Then it has us also kind of mark the angle of our shoulder line. And the reason why this is kind of strange, I think I might actually skip this step. It's up to you guys if you want to do it or not. I don't mind at all. But they're kind of setting us up to add in a dart right here. So they just want it like spaced a little bit. I think they say how much, like 3/4 inch. And then they're going to have us trace the front neckline 3/4 inch away from where we finish the back neckline. This blue line would be like the front neckline. And then later we can make some dart legs and there would be a dart right there. Maybe that's just for a really good, excellent fit. I'm gonna get a little crazy and skip the dart and we'll see what it looks like sewn up. And if it looks okay, skip the dart. But if it doesn't, then you know, okay, maybe I should add in the dart. Okay, so I'm gonna get my front piece, the letter A. And same thing, I need to flip it vertically. Okay, I think I also need to flip it again horizontally. There we go. Okay, and I'm gonna line it up. Oh, maybe why they do the dart is maybe because the shape is funky. I wonder if that's why they do it. I can always rotate it though, my pattern piece. I'm gonna kind of get it to match my shoulder line to be sort of parallel. Maybe that will help smooth out, oopsies, the weird neck shape. I mean, we could always just clean it up ourselves too. kind of playing with this. Should I just rotate it so it looks nice? Okay. Maybe rotate it more. I know I'm going rogue. I'm not following the book right now. Okay. I like to experiment with Chloe because it just sews it up right away. There we go. Let me zoom in. Oops. I have to make sure I'm selecting the right pattern. Here we go. Okay. No, okay, fine. There we go. Okay. Let's see. Okay, now what should we do? We have our neckline. Okay, so where D is, we should probably, D is dropped, and we basically need to, from this little point right here, we need to kind of come up to D, and probably about like where the shoulder guide is. I know I rotated my shoulder guides, so I'm probably just going to do it in the middle. I kind of want to draw some sort of like curve to finish my hood. So I'm going to hit the letter G and do an internal line. I'm going to click it right here. I'm going to hold down command and just kind of click, click. And that's going to be my shape. It might be a little funny. I don't know. I can always go fix it later. It looks like they put in a dart here. Maybe what I'll do is just go ahead and trace my pattern because it is getting a little confusing. So I'm going to select all my pattern pieces with the trace tool. So that's already selected. I'll hold shift. I'll pick you. I'll pick you. And then you. Did I get the center front? I can't tell if I got it or not. Click you. Right click. Trace this pattern. Perfect. Great. Okay. So let's see here. Scooch in. So they want us to put a dart up here. It looks like they do 2.5 inches by 2.5 inches. Should I skip the dart? Should I do it? I don't know. Maybe I'll just do the dart for fun right now. I mean, why don't I just sew it up and see what it looks like first, and then I can go and add the dart after.